was a little bit mixed there. But the word that I'm stuck with is should.
Right.
They should be in a hospital. And I just have a little curiosity around that. Like,
well, I don't know if I said a point that way, but I do think that individuals who are seriously mentally ill should be in a therapeutic setting. You know, I'm not a libertarian who thinks it's great to, you know, better to die with your rights on. You know, I do think that there is some paternalistic role for society to intervene when an individual is very, very ill and sick. And so, as an ethicist, I use the word should all the time. I'm, you know, I'm making normative claims. I wouldn't say that that's, you know, that claim itself is, we'd have to have a conversation so I could nuance it out more, but the general idea that individuals shouldn't be dying on the street or floridly psychotic to me is one I would agree with.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, sure.
It sounded a little bit just incongruent to some of the other part of your message to hear that strong should.
Oh, okay.
That's how it felt to me.
Okay, fair enough. Thanks.
One more in the back.
So we're going to end it there for questions. Tom will be around.
So you should not say should. So the
not should.
Again, I'll use my privilege at the end here. There was an article about 2 years ago called ACT Teams, the Neo-Asylum. And I know I have a number of ACT Team colleagues, probably over 15 or 20 of us in this room. And the article from it was written by a consumer who was arguing that that was too extreme a violation of civil liberties. We keep showing up, we don't go away. But the premise that was kind of underpinning that to me misses a point clinically that I just want to throw out. Having done ACT work for 12 years, I could name people who, no matter how much we intervene, are never going to get well under that community model. If they don't believe they're ill, then the only alternative would be to detain, right? You can use the word incarcerate, but to detain. And if you're detaining somewhere, then the fundamental question becomes, is it better to be psychotic and free, however you subjectively experience that freedom, or to be clear thinking and in a prison, however nice the prison, it could be a Caribbean resort or a castle, but that sense of I'm able to go out and be where I want to be seems to me clinically and personally and subjectively to be something that I struggle with when we think about this model. But I do want to thank Dom and congratulate him, and I have said many times over the years, there are certain people I have seen suffering, I've seen them well, and we don't have a place, whatever we call it, where we can offer them a chance to flourish and to live their lives as they want to live them. So thank you for that. And with that, you of course get the famed Canadian miniature moose and the hat for the national holiday tomorrow. You are getting binoculars. So as you continue to speak the truth, you can see them come. Ah. You just need 3 minutes for a computer switch. Thank you.
Well, yeah.
No, I didn't.